with our schedule number 3. Today we are going to start with our schedule number 4. Yes. Schedule number 4 of physics, that is work and energy and simple machine. So today I'm going to just teach you about the concept of work. So you might be thinking, work? What is a work? You might be thinking, homework? Just tell me about what is meant by the work. Homework or anything else? Yes, you have to do your homework or the work at your home. Yes, the concept work, it means in physics, the work concept is nothing but for that we will do one activity. Just go back, pause your video and bring your book for in a while. I will stop for 1 minute. Take a book in your hand. Yes, have you taken your book? Yes. Now show your book. See, I'll keep in my hand. Whether I'm doing any kind of work? No work. I'm not doing any kind of the work. Now when I will move up or down, at that time I can say I have done some kind of work. So come on, do with me. Just pull your book up or down. At that time you can say the work is done. So can you define the work in physics? The foo. For holding a book, you need some kind of force, yes or no? So, work is defined as force, that is F. And when you say that work is done, when the displacement takes place. When the displacement takes place. When displacement of an object takes place, that time we can say the work is to be done. So in physics, we can define the work as force into displacement. Force into displacement. That is called as a work. So can you just tell me what will be the unit of an work? What will be the unit? Okay. Just now we will find here the unit of an work. So can you tell me what is the unit of the force? It is nothing but Newton. Yes, we measure the force is equal to Newton. And to measure the displacement, we take the unit meter. Yes, so N into M, this is nothing but we call it as a joule. We call it as a joule. So SI unit of an work will be joule. SI unit, that is what is meant by the SI, what will be the full form of SI? That is System International. That is System International. The SI unit of the work will be a joule. Okay, then we can say, now I have told you what is actually the work. Work is nothing but displacement is required. Now see, if you are standing and if a person is standing and he is holding a 40 kg of the bag in the backside, whether he is doing any kind of the work? Yes or no? No. We can say here he is not doing any kind of the work, because we can say that work is said to be done only when the displacement takes place. Only the displacement means when the person will move from one place to the another, that time only we can say the work is to be done. Are you getting this? So the definition of work is nothing but force into displacement. Are you getting this? So can you tell me what is meant by the positive work and what is meant by the negative work? Can you just guess this, what is meant by the positive and what is meant by the negative work? Can you tell me? See, when force and displacement are applied in the same direction or in the same direction. Now see, now if I want to take this, now this is a pen, okay? If I'm applying the force and the direction is also same, then we can say that it is the positive, then we can say it is a positive work. Then we can say it is a positive work. And what is meant by the negative work? When both acts in the opposite direction, then we can say it is in the negative direction. For example, now see, when I am pushing this up, but there is one force is applied by a earth. So what is that force? Can you tell me? Yes, it is nothing but a gravitational force. It is applying in the opposite direction. See, when you jump up, you come directly down. Because of the gravitational force, the earth pulls you up down. Yes or no? So because of that, it pulls you down. As it pulls down, it is nothing but a negative force is applied on that object. So that at that time we can say the work is done in a negative direction. Are you getting this? So today we have learned the concept of work. That is, work is nothing but force into displacement. Then unit of work, that is Newton into meter, it is called as a joule. Then what will be the CGS unit of work? Can you tell me? See, Newton, what is the CGS unit of the force? It is nothing but a dyne. It is nothing but a dyne. Yes or no? And how we can measure the displacement? By a centimeter. And this is called as a erg. What it is called? Erg. Okay? So, SI unit or the MKS unit of the MKS unit of a work is said to be a joule. This is a SI unit. While CGS unit of a work is called as a erg. It is nothing but dyne into centimeter. Are you getting this? Then, to do any kind of work, we need something. That what is that? Can you just tell me? Now see, if I want to hold this or if I want to throw this, I need some kind of what? Energy. Yes, you are right. Now I am speaking, I am continuously talking. Am I right? So I need some kind of energy. So can you define energy? So energy is nothing but a capacity to do work. To do anything, we need a energy. So that is called as for any kind of the work to be done, we need a kind of energy, some kind of energy. So that is called as an energy. So the capacity to do work is called as a energy. While SI and CGS unit of work and energy are same. What I have told? SI and CGS unit of work and energy are same. So what is the SI unit of energy? It is nothing but joule. And CGS unit of energy is nothing but earth. In the next video, I am going to teach you about the types of energy. We will learn the different types of energy. So today's work is that whatever I have taught you about work, you have to make the notes on it and complete your work. Okay?